We've come to the end of the Science of Soil Health series, and I'd like to hand over to Dr. Ray Weil, who describes the soil health movement and the science of soil health in a most eloquent way. I think you'll agree with me.
I think we're in a stage now, I actually think we're in a revolution. It's just, it's such an exciting time to be in agriculture. After really a century of agriculture kind of going downhill, production going up, but in a very unsustainable way, and actually in a way that isn't even sustaining farmers. So the average age of farmers kept creeping up, so it's in the 60s now. I mean, nobody wanted to really be a farmer. Kids of farmers didn't want to do it. It wasn't exciting. It was sort of a treadmill, and frankly quite dangerous, part of the danger being the chemicals that the farmers dealt with, as well as the big machinery. And now we're entering a period where some of the leading innovative farmers, definitely the farmers are leading this. So part of the controversy is that the scientists are chasing behind, and you know, these things seem to work. Can we explain why they're working? We don't know. There's a lot we don't know, which makes science exciting. If we knew it all, we'd kind of retire, right? And then we're starting to talk across disciplines. So the agronomists and the soil scientists that work in agriculture are now working with molecular biologists that are extracting DNA from soils in a more pure system or pure ecological sense. And we're finding that this complex ecology is in fact taking place even in a monocrop soybean field with 300,000 plants or a cornfield with 60,000 plants, all the same species. You think right. There's not much diversity, but in fact there's a huge amount going on that we don't know about. Lots of unanswered questions. So I talked about the communication between microorganisms and these things. We know that this is happening. We have instances of it. We know these signaling compounds are occurring. I think that typically the sort of applied agronomist is sort of behind on that. They're just starting to learn about it. And so it becomes difficult to integrate all this information and what can we do practically. And cover crops is one of those practical things that we can do. We don't know all the reasons why they work. You know, our group has investigated. Some people were trying to learn that. We've learned now, I think, about the bio-drilling and how that works. We were quite surprised at how the weed suppression aspects work. We thought it was chemical, but it turns out to be physical, light kind of thing. So there's a lot to be learned, and yet the farmers are moving ahead and seeing what works. They may not know why it works, so the scientists are trying to figure out the whys.
It's now January 2016, over 2 years since we posted our first video in this series. Since then, we've posted another 27 videos and we've had 180,000 views and great feedback from viewers like you. Thank you so much. I'd also like to thank the scientists who were so kind to work with me, to talk to me in the field, and then also to work with me on editing and reviewing these videos. And finally, I'd like to single out the NRCS's David Lamb and Ron Nichols, who helped to conceive this idea and have been such great supporters for this video series. I look back on this project with a sense of deep gratitude for all of the things I have learned and all the relationships that have been formed. Once again, from the bottom of my heart, I thank you.